Hello guys, welcome to Review and Advice, your car review channel, which will help you to purchase a good car as per your requirement and a better one. So let's get started. Today the car is the DJR, not Swift. From the front it's clearly visible that it's a very wide car than the previous outgoing model. Some interesting touches are added by Maruti. You will get LED DRLs, projector headlamps, as well as the thick chrome striping which is covered with the fog lamps. What Maruti designers have done is have an interesting touch, like they have reduced the length of the bonnet so that they will get more space inside the car. The engine is same both in petrol and diesel as the outgoing car, but what you will get is more performance, more power as the reduced weight of the car. You will get airbag, ABS, EBD starting from the base level, which is a very good thing and must have features in every car. You are getting 15-inch alloy wheels, which is looking similar to that of Sierra. Interior is completely new, the first time in DJR, 7-inch touchscreen is coming. Then AC vents are redesigned, it's looking very good. Few wooden touches are there in the dashboard as well as the steering ring. New round shape instrumentation clusters are there, which will give you a sporty feeling. This new DJR will give you the sense of space. How? Now everything is in light color, be it is the lower part of the dash or maybe the seats, also the floors, all are in very light color. Look at the newly designed gear knob. Don't you think it's very attractive? It's very beautiful. It seems it's coming from a higher version of the car. The base of the gear knob is also chrome lined, it's looking good. For the current version of the car, it is the AGS or AMT. Below the AC knobs, you can find the 12-volt socket as well as the USB port. One thing you will miss in the new DJR is that there is a cup holder earlier in the previous car, but here there is no such cup holder. Apart from that, you will find good quality of plastic over there in the dash as well as the seat cushioning is very good. The under-thigh support has also improved. Guys, moving to the back seat, you can see how spacious is this. The main strong part is the legroom. If you see the earlier DJR, there is very little amount of legroom. The front seat, you will have to touch it if you are over 6 foot. The width of the seat is also very good. Three adults can be seated here properly without any hesitation. So the main strong part for which some of the buyer deviated from purchasing any Maruti DJR to like other cars like Accent is the rear AC vent. So Maruti has addressed this issue by providing a rear AC vent. If you see the rear AC vent and the back seat also, there is a lot of gaps. So 3 seat comfortably in the back seat. I would suggest that before you purchase this vehicle, if you are more than 6 foot long, then try to be seat in the back seat, because what I feel in the back seat, whenever you will sit, your head will be directly touched to the roof. So also try to check if you are comfortable, then only go for it. Else this issue needs to be addressed by Amma. Now you can understand why Maruti is justifiable given the car name as only DJR, not Swift DJR. If you remember the outgoing car's boot, it was looking like a small boot is just attached to the Swift hatchback, nothing but. There is a kind of odd design element in the backside. However, here Maruti designer has done an excellent job by giving a proper shape of the boot. It's not looking like attaching anything to a hatchback, it's looking proper sedan kind of a style. So if you look on the Sierra and this car, it looks familiar. From the side, the height is reduced, however the ground clearance is the same. That's why only there is a difficulty in sitting in the back seat of this car. The boot is also wider. If you see, there are interesting elements like chrome bar is there, the LED lights is there also in the backside, which is the first time in DJR. If you see, there is a huge logo of AGS, that is the automatic gear shift. Instead of AMT, you can say it's AGS. You can see it's a flat boot and there is no issue while loading the luggage in the boot. So it's pretty much more space than the previous version of this car. So guys, that's all from my end. I hope you like this video. Kindly give a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel so that any new video will come up, you will able to get the notification. Thank you, bye bye, and drive safe.